Hello everybody, welcome to back to Tree Spice. I had a comment on my last video asking if I could show how I made my neocender, and so that's what I'm gonna do today in this video, is talk about how I made this and then show you how I make the foot loop that can just stay on your boot, because I actually just broke mine. And you know, that's one of the downsides to making some of your own stuff, is that, you know, it's not the refined product that you would get from a manufacturer, but you know, you can tailor it to what you want it to do, and you know, make it work for yourself. So if you got the time and want to save some money, more having plenty of time than wanting to save some money, then I would recommend going this route and building your own, especially because you can make something that packs up into something much more compact, like this system, as opposed to one of the Saka systems or something like that. So yeah, today we're gonna work on this neocender a little bit. So in absence of the foot loop, this is kind of my setup right now. I just have the tether that goes down to your foot with just a regular carabiner on it. And then I have some elastic up here. Oop, that goes to the XSRE carabiner, just this little guy. I did not buy this carabiner for this. These things are really cool, but they're kind of expensive. I probably would have just bought something from Home Depot or whatever, if I didn't just have this lying around from my captain hook. But something I will talk about with regards to material choice is I would not recommend using a flat elastic like I've done here. You can make it look kind of clean by sewing it up, but if this is not guarded, it'll get really fluffy if it gets caught on stuff. So during your ascents, this is fine, but if you don't take it off right away and you start swinging around, it'll get caught on stuff and get messed up. And that's what happened to my original loop that went around my foot. This elastic was unprotected and it got all shredded up and turned into a mess. So what I would recommend instead of this is instead using some elastic cord. Now this stuff isn't very thick. I don't remember what size this is. Maybe like 1/8 inch, maybe probably smaller. Nah, that sounds about right. But some of the really good cordage for this is like, if you have a tree motion saddle, some of the elastic cordage that comes with that to repair the saddle or make new gear loops, I would highly recommend using something thicker like that. I just wanted something fast and easy, so I bought this from the fabric shop, and I'll eventually replace this elastic with this elastic cord when this stuff finally breaks or whatever. But for now, it's holding up just fine. You really could use any webbing. I'd recommend using something climbing adjacent just for durability reasons. If you can get your hands on some flat webbing, it's kind of unusual to find it in rolls, but this is a lot nicer to sew because it's a lot thinner. This is kind of a special case because this is actually slackline webbing. I just had some low test weight slackline webbing that I happen to have on hand and wasn't going to be using anymore, so I started cutting that up to use this for this project and other projects. But somewhere I'd recommend, I'll link it below, is a company called Sailrite. I've gotten nylon webbing from them to work on my harness. But you can, on Sailrite, you can pick your webbing in different poundage ratings. So I would maybe recommend something in like the 2,500 pound range instead of like something life support like I have. I think I bought for my harness some 5,400 pound rated nylon webbing. But yeah, you want flat webbing because it's going to be a lot easier to sew. You could also use a spliced rope. Using spliced cordage might be even lighter weight and less in the way than this. I know the Splice Witch on their Instagram I saw used like some, it looked like am steel, like really thin, like maybe like 3 to 5 mil am steel. So it had this awesome, super compact setup. For the ascender that I went with, this is a Petzl Croll large chest ascender. I just wanted the large because I wanted something that would work with 13 millimeter ropes. So that's why I went with the large. You could go with the small and I bet it would tolerate 13 millimeter ropes pretty well. But I didn't want to really hedge my bets and just go for the safest option and just get the large, since I think they were the same price wherever I saw them. But yeah, so I'll get to fitting that foot loop now. So this is my old foot loop design. Basically what it was is you just have these two loops and then there was an elastic piece that went in between here. Now, the reason it failed so quickly in retrospect was because that elastic banding was kind of unprotected. So I was leaving it on my foot, which I hadn't done much. Usually I'd just take it right off my foot when I was done with my ascent. But I was like, you know, I designed this to be separable just in case I was like working pruning a silver maple or something, like a really big one, and I was ending up using my knee ascender a lot. So I left it on, and you know, the white pine had a lot of sharp twigs and everything, and it just shredded that elastic. So I think instead of this design where I have two, it was also kind of annoying to clip. It wasn't as fast as I would have liked. So the design we're gonna go with this time, the root to protect the elastic. So instead of having two separate things, which are actually a little bit harder to clip, I'm just gonna make it one big loop. So I'm just gonna sew this into a kind of oversized loop. So this would obviously easily fit over the boot. I'll probably make it a teeny bit tighter than this. But then, so it'll just be this regular circular loop, and then I'll add some elastic on the inside to tighten it up on the boot, and then you would just clip the top of the loop. So that's probably the simpler way to go and probably more durable. So we are gonna see how that works. With the regard to the thread that I'm using, I've been going kind of with like the Sailrite standards. So even though none of this is life support, but I'd like it to be durable enough to be load-bearing, I am using a thread that I believe to be whatever I found at my Joann Fabrics. It's like outdoor upholstery thread, all polyester. It is supposed to be, based on the measurements, close to like V92 thread. So just make sure you have the right needle for that. And basically what I do is, I don't really have any specific settings that I use on the sewing machine. I just do bar tacks because they look cool. It looks like other climbing gear. I don't know, I think it looks cool. So what I do is I just do a straight stitch and then just do a regular zigzag pattern over that straight stitch. And I just make it a little bit denser than usual. But this isn't life support, so it doesn't really matter how you do it as long as it lasts a while for you and just is able to hold your weight. So right now I'm just fitting it to the boot. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sew on the elastic first, and then I will close the loop. So I think this would work better if I had less elastic, but the more elastic you have, the more likely that it's gonna be able to fit over a couple different boots, you know? Got a little bit more range to stretch with. So I'm gonna try to anchor the elastic low so I have room to stitch this loop closed, and I don't want any of the stitching sitting at the top of the loop, because that'll be weird to clip. I don't want to be clipping the carabiner over the stitches, you know. Don't really want to do that with slings, so I'm not gonna do it with this foot loop. So I'll just say this goes marked down here close to the welt of the boot, and then I'll stretch it decently tight and go almost down to the other welt. That might be too much. We'll just go maybe like an inch up from the welt and over and say that's probably good. Hey, all right, so I have a couple dots there where I want the elastic to be attached, and now I'm gonna get to sewing. Now, it's not the cleanest looking. I gotta trim some of that crap off. But I did basically a bar tack along this edge because I don't want to sew up too high on the elastic, because I don't want to lose elasticity from my measured length. I didn't give myself that much seam allowance, so I'm just doing a bar tack basically just on the edge of this webbing. And if you want to know what the specs are for the bar tack that I did, it was a 5mm wide zigzag and a stitch every 1.4 millimeters, I think. Yeah, 5 millimeter wide, 1.4 millimeters long. I think, I don't know. Those are the numbers on the machine. I don't know if they're actually millimeters or not, but yeah, let's sew the other side now. It. Let's see, test fit, how'd it fit? Yeah, that's gonna be nice. That'll stay right there. So now I just gotta stitch this piece closed. And then we'll have somewhere to clip our knee ascender. On these bar tacks, I do three passes with the zigzag. So once across and then back and then across again. And since these are short zigzags, I don't like do a start lock like forward, backwards, forwards. I just do those three passes. And, you know, it's a foot ascender, so not life support. So this one doesn't look great. Something I like to do is try to stay away from the edges, but I always mess up and go over. It's just a, I would guess, a durability thing, but yeah, you don't want to go over the edge with the bar tack. I always forget that it has to advance a little bit to go forward, or to go backwards and change direction again. So there we go. There's our finished foot loop. Is it beautiful? No, not really. But it's gonna do what I want it to do, I think. Hopefully it'll last a little bit longer than the other one. Let's see, how's it gonna fit? Oh yeah, that goes on pretty nice. There we go. And then just clip the carabiner there. Looks all right, just gotta trim it up a bit. Something I would recommend is that you make your foot loop first, because the way I measured this out with the original foot loop was so that the knee ascender would be like right at my knee. So here, I'll put my boot on. We'll see if it's the same length. Oh, and that's the wrong foot, but the boot still goes on. But see, yeah, that's still, maybe it's a little bit longer than before with this new foot loop, but I got it to be like right about at my knee. I don't know if that's the optimal placement for a knee ascender, because this is the first time I've ever had one and the most I've ever used one, but you know, it works all right. And then when it comes to measuring your elastic, different elastics will behave differently, but what I would recommend is that you put on your saddle inside and then place this piece wherever you want it to be for tending, whether that's on the climbing device you're climbing with, on just your ring, the ring on your bridge where your device is connected to, or if you want it up on one of your side Ds, and then take the elastic and stretch it to the point where it's almost at its non-elastic state, like here. It's stretched all the way out as far as it can be. And then, yeah, so, you know, just make sure it's stretched all the way before you decide on the length that you want. And then, you know, either sew it or tie it on. But yeah, I would definitely recommend elastic cordage for durability as opposed to this elastic tape, because this will get messed up pretty easily. Another recommendation is I've seen the splice switch use surgical tubing, and they have a really cool trick for doing that, just like poking a hole in it and then kind of girth hitching it on your device. But that's also another really cool way to do it. But yeah, this is the knee ascender that I use. I hope some of this was helpful explaining how I got it to work and everything, and how I have it set up for me. But yeah, all right, so I got the knee ascender out here. And this, my favorite new rope that I just got that I plan to splice. This is the hot pink Yale Kernmaster Phantom. So 100% polyester, and it's a double braid kern mantle. So this thing is
beautiful. I love having a long rope again. But had a really great time just climbing up. This is my new favorite way to use the knee ascender. Now what I do is I just clip it to my suspender loop, this part, and that can just stay there when this thing's regularly in use. And then I can just unclip it from here and then get the tether ready and then go down and clip it onto my new foot loop. I love this design so much more. The reason that I clip it here instead of, originally I designed this knee ascender to be attached to the ring here, and I've usually been using my lanyard as my kind of neck tether, because I don't like neck tethers, or I like that thing that the splice switch was doing in designs by DeVries, Peter DeVry. He was also using it. Yeah, I actually know Peter's name. Samantha. Samantha is the splice switch. So Samantha had this awesome tether that came, which I could do on this harness, going from the red ring back here, and then have kind of a neck tether thing, but then it's supported by all my suspenders. Anyways, but because I don't want to do that right now, I do have this awesome adjustable rope bridge. So what I do instead is I get the rope bridge as tight as it'll go for me to ascend, and then here I'll just sit back in this. So now this is a really short bridge. I would never regularly climb like this, but for an SRT ascent, this is pretty awesome. Well, I'm kind of coming in your face there. So with this really short bridge here and my knee ascender being hooked over here, the only downside to this is that my knee ascender will hit the bottom of the pulley on my rope wrench assembly. You'll see that. See, it can come almost all the way up. But really smooth system and super quick setup. I'm super happy about this because now this thing can just go on and off so quick, and with this Petzl adjust, as opposed to the adjustable bridge system I was using on my tree motion, as soon as I'm done doing my SRT ascent, then I can just let out some of the bridge to a normal working length, and then just push the rope wrench up and sit back, and then just boom, take it off my foot loop, clip it through the chest ascender, and then just throw it on my side D over there. Nice and compact here. I can't really spin. Show you this. Oh. Momentum, baby. But now this is just kept really tightly and neatly out of the way. So this would be great for if I was pruning. I could just quickly put away my knee ascender and just put it back on when I need it. But yeah, I'm excited about this foot loop, and I think this is going to last much longer than my original foot loop design. So we'll just get some B-roll of me doing a ascent. And because the Petzl adjust works so well, I can get set up while I'm just sitting here in the air really easily. So let's see. Oop, got my thing all twisted up. Yep, just clip my boot. Oh, that's so much faster now. That was a much better idea. So then I would just stand up into my system, tighten up my bridge to be in really tight, a nice 3-inch bridge there, and off I go. Please let me know if you have any questions, and go have some fun climbing, baby. Woo!